Hello everyone, it is me Vegeta T23 and welcome back to my new What If. Today we're talking about what if Saiyans were good. Before I start, I'd like to mention that I created a Discord server for you to join. The link is in the description of this video, so if you'd like to join in and talk to me and the rest of my fans, it's there. I'd also like to mention that I created an Instagram so you can survey my very uninteresting life. I mainly post OSA stuff. Now back to the video. In the last part, we discussed how everything unfolded, Frieza's up-and-coming tyranny, and our Saiyans moving planets twice, first time on some random planet to hide from cold, and the second time ending their savior duties, at least temporarily. Then everything evolved around them building a new civilization on Earth, making the Earthlings share their home planet under a deal to protect them, being stronger of course. King Piccolo then arrived and Raditz took care of him, as Piccolo spat out his egg. Afterwards, Roshi came over to them after following Raditz to their home, asking if he could train the kids and maybe even them. So Raditz and Kakarot joined Roshi's group. With the recap out of the way, let's continue the what if. At Kame House, they began training right away. Raditz and Kakarot shared some tips and tricks for both Krillin and Roshi to become stronger, while Roshi taught the Saiyans some techniques, including the Kamehameha, which they managed to do on their first try, almost perfectly honed even. In that 1 year, they got to the point where they got pretty powerful, still being weaker than a prince, but rich with techniques, which can give them a higher advantage over him. Meanwhile, Krillin is about 6 times stronger at this point of the story, and is more than ready for the Tenkaichi Budokai. Once at the tournament, they all get ready, with Roshi becoming Jackie Chun to test them. Being a bit more rough, hence remembering who they are, the Saiyans breeze through the matches, even surpassing their own master. The finals, however, were Raditz and Goku, and that went pretty eventful as both had loads of tricks up their sleeves. Being an older brother, Raditz was just a bit stronger, but Kakarot had more techniques, managing to pick up the electrifying technique from Roshi a couple battles prior, managing to lock Raditz in place, damaging him quite a lot and almost knocking him out. Raditz, although pretty scuffed, had energy left to fire a Kamehameha in the sky, bending it right towards the ground on Kakarot. Kakarot was literally in the arena ground as Raditz dealt with the finishing blow, almost winning. And again, Kakarot stood right back up and, really beat up, did the deciding fist of cups with his brother. It ended with 2-way knockout and was up to one of them to stand up in those 10 seconds and claim their victory. Raditz was barely breathing, having the electrifying technique taking its toll on his body, so that left Kakarot the lone one to survive and claim his victory. Raditz was sent to the hospital to heal his wounds. He was badly injured, with a cracked skull, 5 broken ribs, both arms broken, and internal bleeding. Kakarot was told his brother won't survive more than a day like this, but after 5 days, Raditz began to speak and has already healed a quarter of the way there. After 3 weeks, Raditz was sent home. Kakarot was kinda sad that he got all that prize money and pretty much destroyed his brother, so he paid his medical bills and split the remains in half, which pleased Raditz as he was more than thankful. Raditz, however, actually surpassed every Saiyan in their small society, due to him literally being on the blink of his life as he got a Super Zenkai. Raditz couldn't believe his own power and was noticed not only as the strongest Saiyan there is, but also the most important, as he figured the whole Zenkai secret, which everyone began exploiting in a way. After 3 years, the Saiyans realized the Super Saiyan form is only a multiplier of their real power and now knew they were on the right path. Broly now gained control of his Super Saiyan and actually unlocked his true form, but that form was quite uncontrollable, so he kept it to only Super Saiyan. Some of the Saiyans have formed their own path and had a solid career in their Earthling world, being known as the Earth Defenders. One day, Kami came up to the Saiyans, bringing them bad news about Frieza arriving sooner than predicted, which gave them an uneasy feeling. When the prince asked how long, Kami replied less than a week, which got them really scared and they began preparing for Frieza. They asked Kami if they can use the chamber again, but Kami replied they already used every drop of their time in there back then. Now, honest to God, shitting their pants, they did the best they could to prepare and have formed every scenario, coming up with a couple of plans for each one. A week later, Frieza arrives in the outskirts, much like Kami predicted, and the Saiyans were waiting for him at the location already. Frieza was unpleasant seeing the Saiyans and began his killing spree. But he stopped when every Saiyan transformed, and I mean each and every one of them. That took Frieza aback, thinking back in the day, asking himself if they had this power all along. King Vegeta took the tyrant on that instant, but out came King Cold. Broly already took his first steps towards the second tyrant, already getting angry and exploding with a massive green aura. He became the legendary Super Saiyan, of course. The battles began and Frieza had to go in his final form right from the start to even keep up with the Saiyan. Now the Saiyan was overpowered, so Prince Vegeta and Bardock joined in on the fun to tearing Frieza apart, while Frieza at his 100% had no chance. Meanwhile, King Cold was already powered up all the way, and Broly used only a little chunk of his power and tore down King Cold with no remorse. However, Broly couldn't calm down and went for Frieza. The other Saiyans quit fighting and just observed. Frieza then did what they feared of. Frieza threw a death ball towards Earth, and they were too late to stop it while Broly was taking his anger on Frieza. After Broly killed Frieza, he cooled down with no memory of what happened. The prince just said they gotta evacuate as soon as possible. Kami told them of Namek and their Dragon Balls, which can wish of any three wishes. With that, they took as many Saiyans and people they could and departed, watching the Earth get destroyed with tears in their eyes. They knew they had to repay their debts and wish Earth back. Once they arrived on Namek, they began searching for Namek's. They found Guru and explained the situation. Guru understood and helped them with pleasure, even offering to unlock their potentials. Saiyans graciously took the offer and then wished the Earth and the residents back to life. Since it can't be done in one wish, they had to use two. With that, they left towards Earth. Once there, the Saiyans were to be split into the ones who will stay on Earth and the ones that will return to Sadala. Around 3/4 of the Saiyans went back to Sadala, much to the great surprise of the remainders. The ones on Sadala began to wipe the planet of Frieza's soldiers and then started helping others in need, while the rest on Earth got used to like Earth and stayed to help out for any cause. It's been another 3 years and all our main characters have found their love of life. Kakarot accidentally bumped into Chi-Chi during the shopping spree and hit it off because Chi-Chi is a weird woman. Vegeta found Bulma during one of the conferences and they also hit it off, and being a great friend, he hooked Raditz up with Tights, Bulma's sister. Tarbo got interested in one other girl who he found on one of Roshi's parties Raditz and Kakarot went to, and that was Launch. He was intrigued with her sneezing transformations and they too hit it off as well. Every single one married in a time span, and also each one of them expected children. The happiness was kinda broken for a little while when the Red Ribbon Army attacked the city Saiyans resided in. Saiyans just threw them back into their pool of piss they came from, and Prince Vegeta, getting pissed at them, began to slaughter with a heavy heart. With one swipe of a hand, he shot what looked like 100 ki waves and completely obliterated their base. He then left some army brats left till they ran out to their real headquarters, where even Dr. Gero resided in, and then wiped them out too out of sheer rage, sensing pure evil from within them. With that, the rock off of Prince's chest has fallen and he is at peace, hoping for it to last a long time. But troubles never evade the Dragon Ball world, am I right lads or am I right lads? And with that, we're leaving things be for now. Thank you for watching. If you think I drew over female Vegeta, then click dislike, but if you liked the video, hit the like button. If you'd like me to cover your idea in the near future, comment down below, and as always, peace out.